안녕하세요, 물고기 친구들. Hello, everyone. Welcome back. And today we're gonna do a bit too simple, by the way. It's just unbelievably simple. You'll be surprised, okay? Why? Because we're going to make questions today, all right? And there are not much things to say, actually, because Korean is the easiest language to make a question. So, let's figure it out together. Okay, let's look at this sentence. All right, so it says, I am a student. In order to make a question in English, we had to switch subject and the verb. So, I am a student become, am I a student? However, in Korean, we don't. What does it mean? So, let's actually make this sentence first. So, I am a student. How do we say in Korean? I am a student. What was it? Well done. 저는 학생이에요. 저는 학생이에요. So, 저는 학생이에요. In order to make a question, how do we do? We just need a question mark in the end. How does it work? Ta-dan! Done. So, 저는 학생이에요? You just need to make the ending tone up in the end. So, 저는 학생이에요? That has become a question already. So, 저는 학생이에요? 저는 학생이에요? That's a question. Well, very good. Is this a phone? Is this a phone? This is a phone. How do you say? This is a phone. This, 이것은, phone, how do we say? 핸드폰, 핸드폰 is very Konglish, isn't it? 핸드, hand, phone, right? 핸드폰, we don't have the f sound, so we just pronounce it po-po-po-pon. 핸드폰, 이것은 핸드폰, it ended with the bottom consonant, so we need 이에요. So 이것은 핸드폰이에요. 핸드폰이에요. So, question, what do we do? Yes, we put a question mark in the end. So, 이것은 핸드폰이에요? Make a question. 이것은 핸드폰이에요? 이에요? In the end, alright? 이에요? Because if you make 이에요, like goes farther, right? It goes really far apart, so we don't need that much. We have to go down a little bit and then up in the end, all right? 이것은 핸드폰이에요? Then how do we answer this question? Well, to say yes, we say 네, 네. And then how do we say no? We say no, 아니요, 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 네, 아니요. Let's answer this question. Am I a student? 저는 학생이에요? So let's apply to me, alright? 저는 학생이에요? What's the answer? No, so you have to say 아니요. And then 아니요. Who am I? You are not a student. You are a teacher, let's say that, okay? Very good. So how do we say? 아니요. 당신은. Actually, instead of using 당신, I mentioned it in another video before. So 당신은, we don't really say 당신. Instead of 당신, we use the person's name, right? You know my name, right? So 세레나. So let's use this 세레나, all right? Instead of 당신은, all right? 세레나 씨는. You can use 당신은 as well, it's fine. 당신은 or 세레나 씨는 학생 아니에요. 세레나 씨는 학생 아니에요. Serena 씨는 or 당신은 선생님이에요. 당신은 선생님이에요. How do we say the negative question then? Guys, pay attention to this one. It's really important. Lots of people actually make this mistake a lot, okay? So when it comes to a negative question, that actually makes it super hard, all right? Because we say a little bit different way. We're gonna say, isn't this a phone? Isn't this a phone? So we're gonna make a negative form, all right? So how do we say the general sentence without the question? So this isn't, this is not a phone. So how do we say? This 이것은 핸드폰 아니에요. Very good. 이것은 핸드폰 아니에요. Very good. 이것은 핸드폰 아니에요. So let's make a question. So we're gonna be 이것은 핸드폰 아니에요. 이것은 핸드폰 아니에요. Easy. 이것은 핸드폰 아니에요. Then it is a phone. You need to say no. Why? In English, it all depends on your own answer. If your answer is positive, you say yes. If your answer is negative, then no. Right? In English, my focus is on my own answer. No matter what, if the question was negative or positive, it doesn't matter. Right? So that's English. I think that's majority of languages are like that, right? And think about in Korean. We are more focusing on the question, not your own answer. It doesn't matter. Imagine like this. If you agree with the question, you have to say yes. If you're not agree, if you disagree with the question, you have to say no. Okay, that's what it happened. It's so confusing. I know it is. So if somebody asks you, don't you want some tea? How would you answer in English? If you want it, yes, please. Yes, yes, I'd like some, right? Yes. And then if you don't want it, you will say, no, thank you. No, thanks. No, I don't want it. Thanks a lot, right? Yes, I do. No, I don't. However, when it comes to negative question in Korean, so let's actually say, let's pretend that we heard this question in Korean, all right? So don't you want some tea? And if you want it, because the question is, you don't want tea, right? It's like that. Imagine like this. You don't want tea, right? You don't want tea, but I want it. So you're not correct. No, 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 you're wrong. No, 아니요. I want it. And if you don't want it, yes, I don't want it. Because the question was, you don't want tea, right? Yes, you're right. Yes, 네, I don't want tea. Does it make sense? I know it's a little bit confusing, but you need to get used to it, all right? So why don't you make some questions and answering together, like, do you want some tea? I don't. However, we didn't learn these terms yet, right? So what shall we do? We just need to make sentences using 이에요, 아니에요, like we did earlier. If somebody asks me, aren't you a student?
"당신은 학생 아니에요? 세레나 씨는 학생 아니에요?"
"네, 아니에요. 네, 저는 학생 아니에요. 저는 선생님이에요. 네, 아니에요. 네, 저는 학생 아니에요. 저는 선생님이에요."
Does it make sense? So well done, guys. You need to change the words. You have to expand your vocabulary, as I keep saying, all right? And keep saying things around, all right? It will be very helpful. So very good. Well done, guys. And see you next time, all right?
안녕히 계세요.
Bye.